Hey, how's it going, guys? Back again with another video. And this one, I didn't ink, and I like to slap my drawings right before I start. So I wasn't gonna make a video on this, and if it sounds like I'm kind of backing off from the mic a little bit, it's because I keep looking to my left. To my left to see the footage. This was honestly so relaxing. I thought of many, many things as I was drawing this. This is called the mucus dome. Music dome. I took my time with this, as I always do with all my drawings, but this one really took me a couple of weeks. I'm looking at the footage right now. It's a bit choppy since I'm watching it from Premiere Pro. But anyways, like, you have to be very exact. You have to get into the little tight lines and all this, especially with a brush. And I had many size brushes, as you'll see on this video. But like when I'd get into the detail, man, I'd get lost. Like, not only that, I would listen to music, and I would listen to a lot of creepypastas. You know, like the greats, Creepsmith Pasta, Mr. Nightmare. He doesn't do creepypastas. What's another one? Lazy Masquerade.
A bunch of those dudes. They're pretty interesting. They're awesome. I love it. I just honestly love it. But what I had for this drawing, I imagine so many things. Like, this is a dome. It's supposed to be in this circular, you know, this spherical, you know, kind of like, I don't want to say container, but kind of like a park. Yeah, you can hear a lot of vehicles out there, by the way. I just imagine like this for no reason. I just like made up a story. Like, oh, it helps with the acoustics. And I guess that kind of helps. And it's supposed to be like, I don't know, like goldish, like, I don't know exactly the metal. I'm not gonna get too much into the details.
Like, what I had, like imagine this: you walk into this dome, right? And it's beautiful. It's not from this planet. It's from somewhere else. I call it the music planet.
If I don't know, that just didn't sound original.
But I like would imagine that there's like these animals, kind of like, you know, like Pokemon. Except you can't capture them. You can't capture them to have. Oh, that would actually be cool. Like, kind of like Battle of the Bands.
That would be awesome with animals, just without, you know, torturing them or anything. Imagine like you walk into this forest. I'm probably dragging on way too much with this. And you walk in and you see these animals. You see these stones, right? Like, they're these there's these transparent ones, and then when you sit down on them, it makes a note, right? And then there's another one right next to it. If you sit down on that, it makes another note, and then you can synchronize them. Everywhere you go, it's music. Except here's the thing. So imagine you walk into this creepy area, right? And it's like kind of like what you see in a typical Halloween movie, where messed up trees, old, and like all this stuff. They're just like nasty, right? I really need to expand my vocabulary. But right there in that section, you would hear something like death metal, or like something like that, where you hear the roar or something like that. You know, I'm not gonna do that again. But I say but a lot. I like nothing. I also imagine like if there's that section, then there should be another section where like you see like these trees that kind of like curl up and stuff. And I don't know what I'm doing with my hands. In that area, that would be where the classical music, you know, where it lies. And I don't know, like in another section where there's like, I don't know, like some right there, that would be some like very colorful, very bright, vibrant. I mean, not to say that, like, in my head, all these places are, they're vibrant, but they're vibrant in their own way, if that makes sense. Like, I don't know. I kind of want to get into it, but I don't know, like, for example, something like the techno section would be a lot brighter than the dubstep. The dubstep would have somewhat darker colors, but also like kind of like mix up black with red and you know, dark color, you know, contrast. Yeah, exactly what I'm trying to say. I also added Dragon Ball influence, kind of. It was just one. I think I added a couple. It's because it's been a while since I did this drawing, and I just colored it right now. I added snake way. You can see it starts from left to right. And that's mainly because a person that wanted me to draw this for them, they asked me if I could add snake wave. And also, I think I should have added more musical elements. The plants hanging off the tree. I like to think they're ginormous fruits. And By the way, this tree is supposed to be huge. I'm talking about huge. Like, it almost touches the top of the dome. Because on the bottom, you can't see in the footage. I messed up. I didn't really set it up right. But on the bottom, you can see these small houses, like a little village. And then you would think, like, wait, why would there be a village when there's huge fruits? And I'm just gonna say that they're well, this makes sense. If you think about it, they're underneath this floating ring, right? So they're not gonna get hit by these ginormous glowing fruits. I don't know what these fruits do. In my head, I don't know. I didn't really come up with a story. Like, there's even a building in the back that shoots a beam into a crystal, and the crystal deflects it onto the moon. Like, it's calculated, you know, in their own scientific way. There's no story there. It just occurred to me. It was random. I liked it. My hair's such a mess, just like this picture right here. But, you know, there also is some symmetry. There is perspective. There's, you know, I did have to look at videos with YouTube to relearn, like, force perspective and a bunch of other stuff. I even had to relearn how to use a protractor because I was never good at that. But yeah, I think I did a pretty good job here, if I do say so myself. The moon, honestly, if you want to draw a moon, it is not hard. It just zoom into it, look at it as much as you can. It is not hard to draw a moon. It is really not that hard. I just use like 3 shades, I think. And I think I use like 4, but that's because I had all these markers and I was like, I'm just gonna use all of them. But you basically do like a bunch of C's, kind of like U's, C's, like rounded, very rounded C's. I don't want to say U because that'd be more a bit sharper. On the dark side, you would draw a white C, and then on the brighter side, you would draw a black C, but the other way, kind of, and that would make a crater right there. And to me, it was just so much fun because there was not much thought to it. I mean, at first, just because you're trying to figure out the lighting and like references and stuff like that. But after that, it's a breeze. What wasn't really a breeze was snake way. Like, I know for a fact that is not even. If that were to be fleshed out, like somehow come off the page, it would not be. All the scales would be all over the place. But I did the best I could. I didn't use any measurements or anything there. I kind of just freehand it for some parts. I remember I had to be as even as I could with the ring. I wanted to make it look like it was an elegant, like it was made out of stone, you know? And anything that has, you know, that's made out of stone, most of the time it has symmetry. So I use ruler for that. It's supposed to float, you know, just like it's this magical place that it's kind of like Pandora from Avatar, kind of like that. It's just very colorful instead of just blue and purple. Nah, I'm pretty sure those 4 colors in that, but I wish, I kind of added some Avatar vibe. I mean, at the end, I did edit it on Photoshop to make things look like things are glowing and like make sure the colors are right. Honestly, it looks a lot better in person than on video when you're like first recording it. So that's why you add all these filters and stuff. Even in the, when I was scanning it, it didn't seem to come out as bright. Like, it's almost there, but it's a bit dull. I added some effects on the Photoshop. Yeah, I'm in a bit of a hurry to finish this video because I'm about to go somewhere and I'm really trying to speed things up. Also, my hair's a mess. Look at that. Jesus Christ, look at that. Oof. Alright, that's enough about my hair. Honestly, I would love to do something like this for another video, like where I actually draw very detailed, not just draw like action heroes or like action poses. And also, I want to get into drawing more females because there's not enough of that. Anyways, here's a piece. I hope you like it. And I added some stones in there just because it has nothing to do with Thanos or anything. It just, you know, just so happens to look like it. There's a blast. There's that car. And there's the end of the video. Thank you so much for watching. And I hope to see you in the next one. Okay, and thank you so much for watching. If you liked the video, please like and subscribe, or subscribe and like. It truly doesn't matter. I won't judge you for that. But anyways, I'll see you in the next video, and I hope you had as much fun watching it as I did drawing it, because honestly, I just had so much fun. So if you didn't, that's all I have to say. Thank you so much for watching.